today I'm gonna be filming this prom makeup tutorial. I obviously do not go to prom because I'm 14 and my lash is falling off. Hold the phone. I hope you guys enjoy. You can watch now. So to start off, I'm gonna start off with eyes because I have glitter for this look. So yeah, I'm gonna use my Tarte shape tape. Excuse me. Oh, okay. Right off the bat, I'm going to explain. So since I just burped and said, excuse me, let me just explain something really fast. Because I'm so tired of people commenting about my burping when honestly, it's the most annoying thing. I hate comments, don't get to me because like, you know, haters gonna hate and I don't care, honestly. Like if you've never burped, then you can judge me, but you don't need to judge me when you're on my video in my safe space. I forget to edit out. Like my burps are so small. And sometimes when I'm editing my videos, like I forget, I don't even realize I burp. Like it's not even a big deal. I don't understand people don't like it so much because God gave us this thing, this ability to burp when we need to relieve our gas. So I don't really know what the problem is, but if you don't like burping and you see me burp in my video and you're like, ew, that's gross, click off. It's not really hard. I don't understand hate comments, like people who hate can comment hate comments, because like if you don't like me so much, then why are you watching? Like, I'm not wasting any of my time. Okay, but I'm not even paying attention. Okay, so I set my eyes with the RCMA translucent powder. I'm just now trying this out, so I'm not really sure how good it is. But I posted this on my Snapchat, and you can add me, Rachel can too, with 2 R's, if you want. But I posted it on my Snapchat, and you guys seemed to really like it, and I felt loved. So, thank you. So I'm gonna say all my brushes that I use in the video, but if you for some reason didn't catch it or whatever, you didn't catch what I threw, then I'll put all the links in the description. Not links, I'm too lazy for that. I'll put all the brushes I use down below in order and all the products and stuff. Okay, so starting off, I'm gonna go in with this blue. It's MT110. This is like a really nice transition shade if you're using blues and stuff, and I really freaking like it. Can I tap this off my finger? I'm a savage, so I do what I want. So we're gonna use this Morphe E27 brush. This is really good for transition colors. Okay, so while I'm blending, I guess I can start reviewing this palette, because a lot of you guys were wondering when I posted about it. Not, if I'm mistaken, please don't yell at me. But I'm pretty sure I've never heard really anyone talk about it before. I've looked it up on YouTube and there aren't a lot of videos about it. There are, but like in German and I don't really understand German. So the colors in it, I think, are wearable for me. And even if they aren't wearable or like you wouldn't wear them on a daily basis, they're still really fun to use. And the colors are so, like, they're so, so pigmented and they're really blendable. And I prefer this over my Morphe 35B, even though the Morphe has more variety and it's like more, you know. This one, it's just, the shadow quality is so much better. It's also more expensive. This palette's $40. But I think that it's just better, personally. I really, really like it. About something really for a second. You see this thing right there? Y'all, sometimes I worry about myself. I don't really know what's wrong with me, but I was tweezing my eyebrows, and this has happened. This is like the fifth time it's happened. And yeah, in case you were wondering and you see that, it's like a really bad scratch. Not really bad. I'm injured. Help. I was tweezing my eyebrows, and I tweezed my skin instead. In case you're wondering, oh, I have that battle scar right there. That's why. I'm going with Morphe M505. And I'm gonna go on with this blue, the MT120. Oh wow. And I'm gonna go on my crease with that. And that's just probably gonna go up a little bit. And then I'm gonna start bringing it down a little bit. I'm not really gonna blend I'm not gonna put too much yet because I haven't shaped out my half cut crease yet. Try not to get too much on your eyelid. I kinda already did. But I'm savage. I'm gonna go back in with this purple. This is the MT100. I'm gonna tap it off and I'm gonna go like back and forth with these two just because I think the purple gives it a little bit of like pop. So I'm going to go back in with the darker blue. I'm going to use the same brush, the M505, and I'm going to go back in with the darker blue to define it a little more. I'm going to pack on the outer corner. You're kind of just going to go halfway across your eyelid, maybe a little bit more than half away from where the inner corner is. Halfway away from your inner corner. And then you're going to kind of start blending it up. And then you're going to blend it in a little bit, but not too much. Or did I yell at you? Sorry. I'm going to cut my half crease, and I'm going to use this MAC concealer, the Studio Sculpt Concealer in NC20. I haven't seen this in MAC last time I went. My friend gave this to me, so I'm not sure if it's still available or not. But it's okay. It's not really the best, and it's not really clean. It kind of like moves around a lot. And I'm going to use the Morphe M508. And I'm gonna carve it out. So I'm gonna start from right here. And kind of bring it up. My eyelid is so freaking big. And the concealer is gonna turn blue. And that's okay. How am I gonna not let this crease? Where's my palette? This is my palette. Is it open? No, it's closed. And I'm gonna find my brush. I'm gonna set that real quick because my crease is like a little bit up more, but I don't want my eyelid to be the white part to be so big. And if the crease is never like, if it doesn't really stay that clean, then you can always go back in with like a defining brush, and then you can go over it with eyeshadow and like define it and make it more popping. So now for glitter. I always say the NYX glitter in my videos. I'm using the NYX glitter. Oh, it's glitter primer. Oh my gosh, I've been saying glitter glue for the last hundred years. Like, what the heck? Glitter primer. I've been saying glitter glue, or like, I've been saying NYX glitter every single time I use this. But then I correct myself in the video and put like NYX glitter glue. It's glitter primer. But it's the same thing. Someone yelled at me for saying glitter glue. Is NYX glitter primer? Don't freaking know. It's right here. I just don't like reading. Actually, I love reading. That's a lie. But it's glitter primer. Oh goodness, look how much that creased. Oh shoot, that looks crusty. So I'm using this Forever 21 brush that I got a long time ago. I thought it was so cool when I bought this brush set. Shoot, look at that floral design on it. That's so cute, honestly. Not that bad of a brush. It's good for glitter because it's like a good shape for it, I guess. You're in that don't get. And then you're just gonna wait for it to dry. I'm gonna go in with the bulk glitters, Slinky Silver. This is the best silver. Never tried anything else, but I know it's the best. Just put it. And you're just gonna bring it halfway. Just stop. Or don't be a savage. This brush is the Morphe M430. I'm gonna blend out a little around it. Well, glitters literally has every freaking color of glitter you could want for $1 each. Hold the phone. Yes, I said $1. I mean, it's not really, it's technically $3 because you have to, they're $1 each, but you have to buy three in order to like buy it, you know? So it's $1 each, but you have to buy three. So it's $3 for three glitters. I'm gonna use this blue. I'm gonna go with the back of this blue, and then I'm gonna go right here where the half crease like stopped almost. I'm gonna blend this part out a little bit. And I'm also gonna add a little bit of the purple and go back in there. Now I'm gonna go in with lashes. I'm using the Coco Lashes in Stella. These are so dramatic. I bought literally the most dramatic lashes I could find. It's like my third time putting on lashes. So right after I put on the glue, I'm gonna put it on like right after. Guess who didn't put on mascara? But guess who put on their lash perfectly fine for once in their life? Well, I'm gonna take that off even though I put it on perfectly well. Literally, best I've ever put on a lash in my entire life. It's wasted, so I'm gonna curl my lashes. I'm using my eyes like a mascara. And I'm gonna put on mascara. So yeah. Eyelashes not on all the way, as you can tell. Courtesy to me being a dumb hoe. And yeah. I'll do my other eye and I'll be right back. But yeah, they look really different. I don't really know what I did wrong or differently, but
whatever.
So I'm not gonna do foundation today just because I'm not gonna go anywhere after this. So I'm gonna use this LA Girl primer and I'm going to put that underneath my eyes. Again, I'm not using a foundation because I only have one good foundation and I don't have money to buy another one. I don't really want to waste it. In my last video, I did my foundation and stuff, so if you want to see how I do it, you can go check it out. Okay, and I'm just going to go off my Tarte Shape Tape. The face is not really my main priority right now. Yeah. But again, I did a better version of my face makeup in my last video. I'm going to use RCMA powder. And I don't really know how to use this because, like, oh, wow. I'm gonna set this, my face with this. I'm gonna tap it in though. Someone said there's like a lot of flashback with it and I'll try it out to see if I like it and I'll update you guys on my RCMA journey. And someone told me to chill the other day. They said, you're 14, chill with the makeup. I do what I want, okay? You're not my dad. You're not my parent. So please don't tell me what to do. Thank you. This kind of randomized a lot of it because I don't understand why age should restrict you from doing things you want unless it's like drugs or something, but I just like love to not stay in their lane. You're gonna crash sometime, so. Oh, that was a good one. Roasted. I'm going to highlight. No, contour. I'm gonna contour. I'm gonna use this Morphe brush from my set. But then I'll set a contour kit in this middle shade. I'm gonna contour. I'm only gonna do my cheeks. That. I kind of want to talk a little bit about my channel. Just a little bit. I always love talking about myself. I'm sorry. So I hit 35,000. I think I'm at 35,000 right now. Subscribers. And okay, so obviously followers are not everything. Emphasizing like, oh, followers. But I kind of wanted to give some thanks because I do it like almost all my videos because my channel's been like kind of, you know, lately. And I kind of wanted to bring it up. And I do a lot, I bring it up a lot, but I don't really sound really sincere almost all the time, just because I'm still kind of confused. I feel like nothing's really changed, but a lot has, kind of, like, follower-wise, I guess. I just want to say thank you, because I think it's really, really cool and nice, and even though there are some haters gonna hate, there's, like, a lot of people that have been commenting on my recent video, and just, like, my videos in general, and, like, DMing me and stuff. And my eyelashes are falling off, hold on. It just makes me like really excited and happy. It's just so cool to me. And I don't know, I just wanna say thank you because that's really nice and I appreciate it a lot. And yeah, I'm gonna try to stay in my lane and not, you know, let the fame change me. I'm kidding, honest, when I say stuff like that, I swear I'm kidding, I don't mean it at all. I'm trying to be funny because I try too hard. But anyways, I'm putting on highlight. I'm gonna use this Essence eyeshadow. It's like $2, and it's really good. It's the Grammy Goes Glammy. I use this for highlight most of the time. And then I put that on my cheeks with the Morphe M501. I'm actually gonna put on a little bit of setting spray. One, because I'm really hot, and two, because else the highlight. I'm putting some on my chin and my cupid's on. So. Oh, and also, y'all, a lot of you guys have seen my recent videos where she's literally in the background of all my videos. This girl is not some homeless girl. She kind of looks like it, so sorry if you're mistaken.
Okay, but if I was a homeless girl, but she's in your home.
Well, yeah, because I'm letting you in. You know, I'm generous like that. This is my little sister. Her name's Kara. I have an older sister, and her name is Anna. And we're not twins, in case you're wondering. But I'm probably going to use it as clickbait and do like a twin tag or something, even though she's not my twin. She's older than me. But yeah, I'm gonna probably do a video with them if you guys want. A lot of you guys have been wondering about her because she just looks sad. Like, honestly, me too, like, feel bad for her. But she's always there just chilling and eating. So, you're relatable apparently, Kara.
That's all I do.
My sister, Anna, she has makeup as well. And I can do, like, doing makeup with my sister because I guess that'd be fun. But she doesn't like me most of the time, so. We'll see. Got this flat brush and I'm gonna put that on my brow bone. So that was it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if this look kind of helped you and gave you some ideas on what you're gonna do for prom or just wear to Walmart, honestly, let me know. And you guys can follow me on Instagram and stuff. On Instagram, I usually like let you guys know when I'm uploading videos if you don't have me notified with like the bell thingy. Yeah, you can follow me on there. And if you like this again, you can give a thumbs up and comment and stuff. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed, and thank you so much for the nice things you guys said about this look on Snapchat. It's really nice. And yeah. Bye guys, I'll see you guys in my next video.